show you now. Just a couple things for vibration sense testing. You want to be accurate, and you want to do it in a good way so that you get accurate information. I didn't mention that I'm hitting the tuning fork with a good amount of force so that I can actually hear that ring. Yep, there you go, you got it. And that way I can be sure that the vibration is going to continue for a long enough period of time that then I can then apply a stopping force to the tuning fork. Because if you just hit it like that, it might just stop really quickly. So I have a good vibration going through the tuning fork. The other points that I didn't verbalize is that I'm actually holding the tuning fork right at the base. You see that? I'm not holding it right here because that'll mute the vibration running through the tuning fork. Okay? And then the other piece that I didn't mention out loud is that when I do this, when I apply the pressure, it's perpendicular to the patient's body. I'm not angling the tuning fork on their skin. So that way they get the full vibration sense. And then furthermore, when I stopped the tuning fork, I made sure that I didn't increase the pressure or decrease the pressure on the patient's body as I was stopping the tuning fork. Okay? So all of those components contribute to a good vibration sense test. In regards to bony prominences in the lower body, so I know the key point is the malleoli on both sides. So in order to avoid going over that bony prominence, just go distal to the malleolus. Questions about that? Did that clarify some things? All right, perfect. Okay, and now I'm just gonna re-demonstrate the pinprick with somebody that doesn't have pants on, so if I can get a volunteer, please. Sit right here for me. Great, thanks. Okay. Yes, question. I need to test for his pinprick first, just like I did for light touch, before moving on to outlining the area. So what I'm going to do is demonstrate that pinprick test now. Okay, so can I have your hands? So I'm going to test on an area of intact sensation that's known. You're going to see this is dull, right? And this is sharp. Perfect. And then I'm going to have her close her eyes. Okay. Tell me yes, and tell me what you feel, sharp or dull, okay?
Dull, sharp.
So she's got all of them correct.
Yeah, she's not acting anything.
Not acting anything, okay? She, whenever dull was appreciated on the skin, she said dull. Whenever sharp was appreciated, she said sharp. I know, she was speaking very, very quietly.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you want to verbalize louder? Okay. All right, so we'll do it again. Tell me what you feel, sharp or dull. You saw is more than 5 points, right? 5 points. But I was keeping track that I did 5 sharp stimulus application to the area that I'm testing, and she got them all correct. that's a kind of like something that you have to keep track of mentally. But I also was alternating right-left to make sure that she wasn't going to guess, oh, okay, they're only testing this side, right? And I was alternating between sharp and dull so that I can get a sense of, is she able to feel that difference? The other component to this was that I was doing it at a random frequency. So I wasn't just going dull, dull, sharp, dull, dull, sharp, sharp, right? So I kind of did some longer pauses in between the presentation of the stimulus, some shorter pauses, and I can now very confidently say that her sensation to pinprick is intact. She got 5 out of 5. But if she would have missed 2 of those, then it would have been impaired, okay? If she would have missed all of them, it would have been absent. Now I can then go ahead and use just the sharp side to outline the area more specifically. Okay? Any questions?
All right, so let's work with our faculty groups, give them